experience of the self, without any media. All our experiences in this world are mediate, means there is some media with which we experience. Media of our senses, media of our mind, media of our intellect. So what we are experiencing is nothing but the media only. When I give opinion about the other person, I am giving opinion of my own mind, of my own senses. But here one becomes, transcends the media and experiences the self, by the self, in the self. So that state is called samadhi. Samadhav achala buddhihi. And this samadhi is the very nature of our self only. That self and samadhi is not different then. And the buddhi get established in this samadhi or in this self. When such a thing happens, Bhagavan says, tada yogam avapsyasi. That is called a state of yoga or state of realization. So you will reach the state of realization by following the path of karma yoga. Bhagavan started by telling Arjuna that, hey Arjuna, that you should fight this war because it is your swadharma. After convincing him by giving so many logic, Bhagavan says, now you fight keeping the mind equanimous in the result of action. Whether victory or defeat comes doesn't matter. There's no guarantee that you will win, you might lose also. But keeping your mind balanced, you fight as a samarpan to the Lord, as a worship of the Lord. As you do this, your mind will start becoming more and more calm, more and more peaceful. And in that peaceful state of mind, you will gain that vairagya. You will gain proper understanding of yourself. All your attraction for the world will disappear. And in that quietude of your mind, quietude of your intellect, when you will reach the state of samadhi. Mind becomes quiet with vairagya. Intellect becomes quiet when all the questions are answered. When the intellect no longer has any doubt. If the intellect has got doubt, it keeps asking questions. Actually, how we as human beings have progressed in this world also because of this questioning attitude of intellect. What is this? How is this? How this earth is created? What is this sun and how the moon is formed? And what is there on Mars and all. This questioning is there, and that questioning is making a human being an explorer. Human being, the beauty of human being is he is an explorer of the world. Therefore, even though everything is good in here, we will go out to see what is happening on the moon. Are aapko kya padi hai? No, I want to see. Then go to the Mars, go here, go there, go into the ocean, go up in the sky, go into the volcano. Everywhere we go to see what is happening. Why? Because this thirst to know is there fundamentally in the intellect. Intellect doesn't keep us quiet unless it receives the answer. It is manufacturing thing. I don't say defect, but it is there with the intellect. So right from childhood, that question is there. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Why you wonder to doodh pilo, chupcha baitho vahan par? Tom and Jerry dekho and we keep quiet. No, why, how I wonder? That little child here on earth, the star is so up. Why you want to wonder unnecessarily? But this is there because our intellect doesn't keep quiet. Spirituality is to turn the attention of the intellect into the inquiry of self rather than inquiry. The spirituality says that if you know who you are, you will know what is the world also. If you know the world without knowing the self, still your inquiry will not come to an end. And if your inquiry doesn't come to an end, your intellect can never remain quiet. And if the intellect is not quiet, you cannot meditate. You cannot reach the state of meditation. Huh? You can meditate, but you cannot reach the state of samadhi. So to quieten the intellect, we should give the answer to the intellect of who am I? And that answer through proper logic and proper scriptures and contemplation, the intellect feels satisfied. That's the beauty of it. Your intellect will feel satisfied if you go through the Bhagavad Gita to authentic scriptures, not later on modern man-made scriptures. Authentic scriptures like the Upanishad, like Bhagavad Gita, when we go through them, they will convince the intellect. And when the intellect gets convinced, it will become quiet. So mind has become quiet, vairagya has come, intellect has become quiet. When the mind intellect is quiet, senses are quiet. And in that quietude of mind, intellect, senses, one reaches the state of samadhi. And once one goes there, one knows and experiences the self which one has intellectually known is directly realized. That is called a state of samadhi. So samadhavachala buddhihi tada yogam avapsesi. So hey Arjuna, just by following sincerely the path of karma yoga, you will slowly and steadily transcend into that upasana, jnana and dhyana and samadhi and become a realized person. You will become a person whose intellect, whose mind is well settled in the self. One who is not disturbed by any doubt, one who is not disturbed by any attraction toward the world, because we are attracted toward the world for joy, because one has discovered the joy within. One is not disturbed by any question or some confusion, because everything is clear once I have recognized myself. Such a state of realization will be reached. So therefore, hey Arjuna, you follow this path. This war is incidental. If something else was there, I would have told you to do that other things. But incidentally, this war is there. So Bhagavan says, you fight this war. If he was a modern, youth or modern person, Bhagavan would have told him, therefore you go to your work. You go to this company. You do your work. You take care of this, whatever the duties. But do it with karma yoga attitude and it will lead you to samadhi. But what happens when I reach that state of samadhi? What will happen if I recognize and realize myself? What is the nature of a realized person? How does he live? How does he walk? How does he talk? How does he interact with the world? That question suddenly arises in Arjuna's mind. And he asks that question. And as a reply, Bhagavan tells him what is the nature of this realized person. So that is the portion further. We will see it from tomorrow.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.